want to succeed in life,
ukitaka kufaulu maishani,
you need to have a certain standard.
Unabidi basi kuweka viwango fulani.
You set your personal standard.
Unaweka viwango vyako binafsi.
You set rigor upon yourself.
Wewe unajinyima.
This is what I will do.
Na useme hivi utafanya.
This I cannot do.
Na hii siwezi nikafanya.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Because I want to be the best.
Kwa sababu nataka nikuwe bora zaidi.
I want to be outstanding.
Nataka niwe wa kipekee.
You cannot become outstanding by being faced the way everybody is doing.
Uwezi kuwa mtu wa kipekee kama unafanya mambo sawia na wengine.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
You have to set standard.
Lazima uweke viwango.
This I will do.
Hii nitafanya.
This I cannot do.
Na hii siwezi.
We have to keep the covenant.
Lazima tudumishe agano.
to walk in the scripture,
tutembee katika maandiko,
to keep God's word,
neno la Mungu tulichunge,
to keep his precepts,
tuweze kuchunga mausia yake.
So by doing so,
sasa kwa kufanya vile,
God's going to walk with us.
Mungu atatembea pamoja nasi.
In the book of Exodus chapter 19 verse 5 and 6,
katika mwanzo ama kutoka 19 mtano mstari wa 5 mpaka wa 6,
put it there,
niweke pale.
Exodus chapter 19,
kutoka sura yake ya 19.
Can you read it now? Therefore, if you will indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured. I want you to underline the word treasure. Treasured possession.
Nataka kuangalia hilo neno kwamba utakuwa
among all people for all the earth is mine.
Kati ya watu wote zamani dunia yote ni yangu.
So you see the word treasure.
Basi unaona neno pale tu.
But before you become treasure,
lakini kabla ufanyike tu,
you have to keep the covenant.
Lazima udumishe agano.
One has to
praise the Lord.
So if we keep God's covenant,
sasa kama tutaweka agano la Mungu,
we become his treasure possession.
Tunakuwa watu wa maana sana kwa Mungu.
God will treasure us.
Mungu atatuona kama tu.
Will put us in his heart.
Atatuweka ndani ya moyo wake.
Put us in his place of security.
Atatuweka katika eneo ya ulindo.
He will put us in a place where he put his best, his beloved ones.
Atatuweka katika eneo ambapo anaweka vitu vizuri.
So that is the first condition.
Basi hicho ndicho kipengele cha kwanza.
Or the first requirement.
Ama hitajika la kwanza.
Or the first aspect.
Ama mtazamo ama direction.
Or the first volley, if you want. Just hey, put it in the language you can understand.
Weke katika lugha ambayo utaielewa zaidi.
Now, to keep the covenant.
Basi kudumisha agano.
It's not something just okay, I keep the covenant.
Sio jambo utasema kwamba mimi nimedumisha agano tu.
To keep the covenant.
Kudumisha agano.
It means to obey the word.
Inamaanisha kutii neno.
To obey the word.
Kutii neno.
Demand for consecration.
Basi inabidi kutakaswa.
Demand for dedication.
Inamaanisha ujitolee.
Demand for commitment.
Lazima ujipeane.
We do not serve God because this is easy.
Hautumikii Mungu kwa sababu ni rahisi.
But we serve God out of commitment.
Lakini tunamtumikia Mungu katika kujitolea.
You set standard.
Unaweka viwango.
I don't want to sin against God.
Ya kwamba sitaki kumtendea Mungu wangu
dhambi. I want to please God.
Nipendeze
na watu obey God.
Nataka nitimu.
I want to follow his instructions.
Nataka nifuate maagizo
yake. I want to do his will.
Nataka nifanye mapenzi yake.
Even when it is very difficult.
Hata wakati mambo ni magumu.
So you fight.
Kwa hiyo unapigana vita.
You strive to obey God.
Unang'ang'ana sana kumpendeza Mungu.
And to please him.
Na kumpendeza yeye.
The Bible talks about Daniel.
Biblia inaongea kuhusu Danieli.
When Daniel went to Babylon.
Wakati Danieli alienda kule Babiloni.
They were captured and then taken into captivity.
Wakapelekwa katika eneo ya utumwa.
Arriving there,
wakati walifika kule,
the king of the land selected Daniel among other youth.
Mfalme wa ile nchi akachagua vijana na mmoja wapo vijana alikuwa Daniel.
Because he wanted them to serve in the royal palace.
Kwa sababu alitaka hao vijana watumikie ikulu.
So Daniel was selected.
Sasa Daniel akachaguliwa.
And the king came up with a menu kind of food that these young people must eat before they start serving.
Alafu mfalme akatengeneza aina ya chakula ambacho hao watu watakula ndipo sasa wajiandae.
And also some training, some teachings they have to go through to become, you know, acquainted with royalty to serve the kingdom.
Alafu wakapelekwa katika elimu na mafunzo ambayo yawasaidia kuelewa mambo ya ufalme.
The Bible says,
leo nasema,
Daniel decided.
Daniel akaamua
not to defile himself.
Ya kwamba asijinajisi.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Because he knew that his success depended on God.
Kwa sababu alijua kwamba ufanisi wake maishani unamtegemea Mungu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that was his first requirement.
Kwa hiyo hilo lilikuwa ni jambo la kwanza.
When we talk about the kingdom of God,
wakati tunaongea kuhusu ufalme wa Mungu,
we talk about us and God.
Tunaongea kuhusu sisi na Mungu,
relationship between us and God.
Uhusiano wetu na Mungu.
And that relationship is to be protected.
Na kule uhusiano ni wa ulinzi.
We need to fight hard.
Lazima tupigane vita.
To take care of that relationship.
Tuweze kudumisha ule uhusiano.
Through sacrifice.
Katika kujitolea.
And dedication.
Na pia kujipeana.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So once you do that.
Wakati unafanya vile.
God will protect you.
Mungu atakulinda.
God will walk with you.
Mungu atatembea nawe.
God will bless you.
Mungu atakubariki.
God will give you connections.
Mungu atakupatia uunganisho. kumaliza.
And make sure you succeed.
Na hakikisha kwamba umefaulu.
Now you have the second aspect.
Basi na kipengele cha pili.
What I call the second aspect to standard for excellence.
Kile ambacho nakiita kiwango kwa ajili ya ufanisi wako.
It is now your personal standard.
Sasa ni viwango vyako binafsi.
If you want to succeed in life,
ukitaka kufaulu maishani,
you need to have a certain standard.
Unabidi basi kuweka viwango fulani.
You set your personal standard.
Unaweka viwango vyako binafsi.
You set rigor on yourself.
Wewe unajinyima.
This is what I will do.
Na useme hii ndio nitafanya.
This I cannot do.
Na hii siwezi nikafanya.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Because I want to be the best.
Kwa sababu nataka nikuwe bora zaidi.
Outstanding.
Nataka niwe wa kipekee.
You cannot become outstanding by doing things the way everybody is doing.
Uwezi kuwa mtu wa kipekee kama unafanya mambo sawia na wengine.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
You have to set standard.
Lazima uweke viwango.
This I will do.
Hii nitafanya.
This I cannot do.
Na hii siwezi.
You set your standard.
Unadumisha mawaidha kwa moyo.
You put discipline.
Unajitia nidhamu.
You subject yourself.
Unajiweka katika nidhamu.
To tough discipline.
Katika nidhamu ya hali ya juu.
This I will do.
Hii nitafanya.
I will not do.
Na hii sitafanya.
I will obey God.
Utatii Mungu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now.
Sasa.
Those personal. They are now personal.
Sasa haya mambo ni ya kibinafsi.
During the week we talked about Paul.
Wiki hii tuliangazia maisha ya Paulo.
How Paul was praying.
Vile Paulo alikuwa naomba.
In the book of 2 Corinthians.
Katika kitabu cha Wakorintho wa pili.
And Paul said.
Paulo anasema hivi.
Through hard work.
Katika kazi ya bidii.
In prayer and fasting.
Katika maombi ya kufunga na kuomba.
Through suffering.
Katika mateso.
And hard commitment.
Na kujitolea kwa bidii sana.
He served God.
Alitumikia Mungu.
And then he talks about the person.
Alafu anaongea kuhusu mtu.
Who was taken to paradise.
Ambaye alipelekwa katika mbingu ya tatu.
And saw things that are amazing.
Na akaona vitu vya kushangaza.
Nobody can talk about those things because they have no names in human language.
Hakuna yeyote ambaye anaweza elezea vile vitu maanake hazina lugha ya kibinadamu.
So he saw things.
Kwa hivyo aliona mambo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amazing things.
Vitu vya kushangaza.
Now you see, before he saw those things,
kabla aone yale mambo,
he had set a standard.
Alikuwa ameweka kiwango.
The standard of hard work.
Kiwango cha kazi ya bidii.
The standard of discipline.
Kiwango cha nidhamu.
Prayer and fasting.
Maombi ya kufunga na kuomba.
Today we are believers.
Leo tuko na watu waliokoka.
Who want to rise up.
Ambao wanataka kuinuka juu.
They want to lead their generation.
Wanataka waongoze kizazi chao.
But they have no standard.
Lakini hawa watu hawana viwango.
They have no discipline.
Hawana hata nidhamu.
If you don't have discipline.
Kama una nidhamu.
You need nobody.
Hautaweza kuongoza yote.
Listen.
Sikieni.
Everybody want to become a success.
Kila mtu anataka kufanikiwa.
Every person.
Kila mwanadamu.
Want to become the head.
Anataka kuwa kichwa.
But not everybody is becoming the head.
Lakini sio kila mtu ambaye anafanyika kuwa kichwa.
You become the head.
Unafanyika kichwa.
The way you carry yourself.
Vile mwenyewe unajibeba.
Discipline is core.
Nidhamu ni ya muhimu sana.
In this life.
Katika maisha haya.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Discipline.
Nidhamu.
The way you carry yourself.
Vile unabeba mambo yako na mwenyewe.
When you talk about discipline.
Ongea kuhusu nidhamu.
It's not a punishment.
Si adhabu.
It is discipline.
Ni nidhamu.
You have a dream.
Uko na ndoto.
You have a vision.
Uko na maono.
Now you want to fulfill a dream.
Na unataka utimize ile ndoto yako.
Now that dream.
Sasa ile ndoto.
Will not be fulfilled.
Haitaweza kutimia.
Until you pay the price for that particular dream.
Mpaka ulipie gharama ya ile ndoto.
Do you understand?
Je, tunaelewa?
You have to pay the price.
Lazima ulipie gharama.
For the dream to come to pass.
Kwa ile ndoto ipate kutimia.
If you don't pay the price.
Kama utalipa gharama ile ndoto.
You die with your dream.
Basi utakufa nayo.
Many people have dreams.
Wengi sana wana ndoto.
They die with those dreams.
Wanakufa nazo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when Paul came to the kingdom of God.
Wakati Paulo aliingia katika ufalme.
He worked very hard.
Alifanya kazi ya bidii.
I want to become the best.
Ya kwamba nataka nikuwe bora zaidi.
I want to become outstanding.
Nataka nikuwe wa kipekee.
You don't become outstanding by pity.
Hautakuwa wa kipekee kwa kuhurumiwa.
You become outstanding through the way you carry yourself.
Unakuwa wa kipekee vile unatenda kazi yako.
So he labored, you know, in a fantastic way.
Kwa hivyo akatia bidii ya juu sana.
Prayer and fast.
Katika maombi ya kufunga na kuomba.
Seeking God.
Anatafuta uso wa Mungu.
How many times when we call people here for prayer? I gave this teaching in Atlanta. In a church. You know what? I asked people a question. What do you say about the work? Where was the way? Because the woman is crying in the desert. There is nothing. They said the way was not there. But God created the way.
Amen.
The Bible doesn't say God created. The Bible says God opened. And then she saw the way. When you read Genesis chapter 2, the Bible says God created everything. Completed his work of creation. God rested from all his work. So God will not go into creation again. He created and finished his work.
Praise the Lord.
God created and completed his work. He will not go to creation anymore. So it means the way was there. But the one could not see the way. Why do we pray? In prayer, we are clothed with the power of God. So prayer now. Enable us to see spiritual things that we cannot see with the physical eyes. Prayer enable us to overcome the things that we cannot overcome physically speaking. The Bible says in Ephesians, we are fighting a spiritual battle. It's not a physical battle. Now, if you conquer the spiritual battle, the physical will answer to you. Now, if in the spiritual you are in bondage, you are in chains, it doesn't matter what we do in the flesh. That's why people sometimes they work until they get tired. That's why people die in their dreams. I'm in this place. That's why prayer is very important. So you have a vision. You have a dream. You need to have discipline. Set some standard of the things you will do. And the things you will not do. So you subject yourself into that. This I will do. This I will not do. This one I will do. This one I will not do. You subject yourself. In other words, we say, be honest with yourself. What did I say? I said the second folle or the second aspect is you yourself. What are your standards?
Praise the Lord.
If you don't have standards, forget about ruling your generation. If you don't have standards, you go nowhere.
Praise the Lord.
It's very important. You need to set the standard. Discipline yourself. Decide what you will do. And what you know
not
do. Even when it is painful. That's the road to success. Amen. Now, the last aspect is now the demand by the consumers. Yes, the consumers. When I talk about consumers, you know, in the church, we are used to the language of the church. The language of the church. When you hear the word consumer or client, it strikes you.
yake.
It's just terms.
Ni maneno tu ambayo yanabadilika.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amina.
I want to use these terms. Na these are terms that are used in the world.
Nataka kuona yale maneno ambayo yanatumiwa kule nje.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Now, what do I talk about consumers?
Bwana tunaongea kuhusu wateja hapa.
Jesus was preaching the gospel.
Yes, Christ was going to be
in. One day, Peter said to Jesus,
Petero, yes,
we have left everything.
Sisi, tumeacha kila kitu.
We are following you.
Na tunakufuata.
What are you going to give us?
Ni nini ambacho utatupatia?
So in this case,
sasa katika hali,
Peter is a client.
Petero hapa ni mteja.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amina.
He's a client.
Yeye ni mteja.
We have left everything.
Kila kitu tumewacha.
We are following you.
Na tunakufuata.
Can you meet our needs?
Je, waweza tikiza mahitaji yetu?
What are we going to get in return?
Ni nini ambacho tutapata katika?
What are you going to give us?
Wewe utatupatia nini?
Bwana asifiwe. So this is very important.
Kwa hiyo hii ni muhimu sana.
This big world,
ulimwengu wote unaona,
is like a market.
Ni kama soko kubwa sana.
It's a market.
Ni soko.
You give nothing, you get nothing.
Kama utatoa chochote utapata chochote.
Yes.
Amen.
The Bible says in Luke chapter 6 verse number
38,
give and it will be given to you. When we read this scripture, automatically we think it is about giving money to church. It is bigger, broader than that. These are realities. Maybe you don't get in churches. Manifata vizuri, especially this language.
Sana sana lugha kama hii.
They will tell you redemption, justification,
salvation.
But there are things that are reality in this life.
Lakini kuna vitu ambavyo za uhalisia na za kweli katika dunia hii.
It be in the spiritual realm or the physical.
Iwe katika ulimwengu wa kiroho au wa kimwili.
Do you understand?
Je, tunaelewana?
Now listen.
Sasa sikia.
Jesus says.
Yesu Kristo anasema
to disciples,
and I'm here with
the Pharisees.
Our Pharisee.
He said, John came here.
I'm here with John. I'm here with John.
He was eating.
I'm here with John.
And drinking.
I'm here with
John. You said John is what?
I said my John.
John is what? Is a demon possessed?
I'm here with my God. I'm here with
you. Rejected him.
I'm here with
God. Now the Son of God has come.
I'm here with God. I'm here.
He is eating.
I'm here with
John. He's drinking.
I'm here with John.
And then you call him a glutton.
I'm here with John.
A friend of prostitutes and tax collectors.
Rafiki wa makahaba na hawa watoza ushuru.
Matthew chapter 11, verse 18 and 19. Now look here.
Sasa ona hapa.
John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say he has what? He has a demon. Who said he has a demon?
Ni nani ambaye alisema kwamba amepagawa na pepo?
Who said?
Nani alisema haya?
The big one. John came with a ministry to minister to people. He was not ministering to himself. Like for example, you minister to Nairobians. And then you go and live, for example, in the desert. Is there a desert here? Somewhere here. Is there a desert? Chalbi desert. Now, you go there, live in Chalbi desert, and then you have a mission to people. But you live in the desert, and then you are shouting there. Only few people went there to hear the gospel. Do you understand? Many said he has a demon. How can a whole human being wearing the skin of a camel, when other people wear clothes, that man has a demon?
Ni vipi katika dunia hii wote wanadamu wamevaa ngozi ya mnyama na wengine wanavaa nguo? Akasema hii ni kupagawa na pepo.
They said the man is funny.
Akasema huyo jamaa si mzuri.
He lives in desert.
Anaishi kule jangwani.
He eats honey.
Anakula asali.
And locust.
Na nzige.
What kind of man is that?
Mtu aina gani?
Do you understand?
Naelewa.
Now, Jesus came.
Sasa Yesu alikuja.
19. Look at this.
19.
The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, look at him, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is justified by, hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, Now, when Jesus came, Jesus now pulled crowds. Now, let's go to chapter 3 of John, verse number 22. Chapter 3, John, verse 22. I want us to read, look at this. After this, Jesus and his disciples went into the Judean countryside, and he remained there with them and was doing what? Baptizing. Another one verse. John also was baptizing at Ainon near Sidon, because water was plentiful there and people were coming and being baptized. 24. For John had not yet been put in prison. Now, a discussion arose between some of John's disciples and a Jew over purification. And they came to John and said to him, Rabbi, he who was with you across the Jordan, to whom you bore witness, look, he is baptizing and all are going to him. And what? Are going to him. So, number 27, John answered, a person cannot receive even one thing unless it is given him from heaven. 28, you yourself bear me witness that I said, I'm not the Christ, but I have been sent before him. The one who has the bride is the bridegroom, the friend of the bridegroom who stands and bear him, rejoices greatly at the bridegroom's voice. Therefore, this joy is mine, is now complete. 28, he must do what? Increase, but I must decrease. Now, look at me. Disciples of John the Baptist came and told him, the man you gave testimony about is also baptizing people. All are following him. We don't have people anymore. All are going there. What are we going to do? Hallelujah. Jesus didn't go and live in the desert. He lived among people. Are you in this place? He ate with people. People were called tax collectors. Prostitutes. People were rejected by the society. Jesus spoke to these people. He was their friends. Brought them to the kingdom. Hallelujah. The Bible says, the kingdom of God. Jesus came for those who are sick. For the sinners. Not for those who are healthy. Only the sick need a doctor. So Jesus came for the sick. Are you in this place? People who are rejected by the society. Jesus said, come to me.
Yes,
I will give you rest. Come to me. I will make you relevant. Come to me. I have a place for you.
Praise the Lord.
Do you know that in the churches, some people are driven away because we don't understand the essence of church. We think church is for people who are holy. Will come to church. Church is not for people who are very holy. It is a place where God is reconciling with his people. It is where the word of God is released to God's people. It is a place of forgiveness. A place of repentance. A place of joy.
Yes.
Some agents do not understand that.
But when you are living here,
they come to church. And then, if they see somebody, maybe smoking, they run to pastor's office.
gani?
Where do you want this guy to go to school?
Wewe unataka mtu akutie sigara hapo?
Let him smoke here.
Wacha akutie sigara.
When there is the word of God,
maana ndio kuna neno la Mungu.
It will affect him.
Itaweza kumwadhibu.
One day he will come to Jesus.
Moja atakuja kwa Yesu.
One day he will smoke.
Moja acha sigara.
Amen. Listen man.
Sikieni wapenzi.
If someone smokes,
kama mtu ana
and enter church.
Naingia kanisa.
Hear the word of God.
Sikieni neno la Mungu.
One day this person will change.
Mtu atabadilika.
You will stop smoking.
Ataachana na sigara.
If someone drinks,
kama mtu analewa,
and attend church.
Hapa ingia kanisa.
One day
siku moja
this person will stop drinking.
Mtu ataacha ulevi.
Ama namna gani?
Amen.
Now you tell me.
Sasa uniambie.
Somebody is in his house.
Mtu hapa katika nyumba yake.
This person doesn't even know Jesus.
Mtu hajui Yesu.
You want him to change in his house.
Unataka badilike maisha yake.
How can the person change in his house?
Ni vipi mtu abadilishe katika nyumba yake?
Are you in this place?
Je, tuko pamoja?
Somebody is a robber.
Mtu ni mkora.
Let him come to God.
Wacha akuje kwa Mungu.
Let him come to church.
Wacha akuje kanisani.
He will hear the word of God.
Atasikia neno lake.
The Holy Spirit will touch, minister the word to the person.
Na Roho Mtakatifu atahudumia yule mtu.
And one day he's going to serve God.
Na siku moja atatumikia Mungu kabisa.
Ama namna gani?
Na kwa Yes,
we have people here.
Kwa watu hapa.
Who are drinking.
Ama leo.
We had a brother called Mukala.
Ya tulikuwa na mtu kama Mukala.
The guy will drink.
Jamaa ke leo.
And become chikumbushi. Do you know chikumbushi?
Yeah.
So he will drink, drink, drink until he become like a pig.
Ama leo. Yeah. Maka, ajielewi tena.
The day he came to get born again.
Si baba aliokoka.
He was drunk.
Alikuwa mlevi chakari.
And we prayed for him.
Na tukamuombea.
We impressed him.
Tukamkumbatia.
We didn't say, oh no, you are drunk. You cannot get born again. We said, you are drunk. We know you will get born again drunk. We prayed for him.
Ya, tukumbatia kama wewe ni mlevi au utaweza kuokoka. Tulimuombea katika
ulevi. Today is a wonderful brother.
Leo ni ndugu mzuri sana.
Ama mwanamke.
Amen.
So Jesus.
Okay, yes.
Ate with the prostitute.
Akala kwa 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 kwa.
Sasa so, unambie. Let's imagine a world where they reject you because you are a prostitute. They cannot help you.
Fikiri ulimwengu ambao watu wanapenda.
They cannot help you.
Hawezi kukusaidia.
They just reject you.
Wanakukataa.
You go and die.
Wende ukakufe.
You are a tax collector.
Oh, wewe ni mtoza ushuru.
You are a thief.
Oh, wewe ni mwizi.
You cannot come to the temple.
Huwezi kuingia katika mahali patakatifu.
Jesus came.
Yesu akaja.
Went to these people.
Akaenda kwa watu.
He met Zakayo.
Akaja Zakayo.
He said, Zakayo, today I enter your house.
Akamwambia Zakayo, leo
nitakula nyumbani kwako. I will feed in your house. He entered there.
Akakula pa.
They brought nyama choma.
Wakaleta nyama choma.
They brought rice.
Wakaleta
chapati.
Wakaleta chapati.
Jesus is eating.
Yesu Kristo anakula.
And laughing.
Na anacheka na
furaha. He said, hey!
Sema kujeni muone.
Things have changed.
Mambo yamebadilika sana.
This man.
Ule mtu.
We thought he was the Messiah.
Sisi tulifikiria yeye ni Masihi.
How is he eating with tax collectors?
Sasa ni vipi akae meza moja na watoza ushuru?
Tax collectors are thieves.
Watoza ushuru si wezi.
They steal from people. Why is he eating with them? How are you going to change them? If you run away from these people, how are you going to change them?
One
has a few. So he ate with these people. And his church was packed. There is a Nigerian preacher. He's in Ukraine. His name is Sunday. Pastor Sande. He has a church of over 30,000 members.
Akuna kanisa la watu zaidi ya 30,000.
In Ukraine.
Kule Ukraine.
Try to imagine Ukraine.
Ukraine.
Do you know Ukraine? That is Russia.
Ukraine kule ni Urusi.
You know? But a Pentecostal church.
Lakini kanisa la
Kipentecostal. 30,000 members.
Watu zaidi ya 30,000.
He went there to study in the university.
Alienda kule kusoma university.
And then he started ministering. Today is a fantastic church. People who are rejected by the society. People dealing with the drugs. He went and collected those people. These religious people. They say this one is bad. This one is bad. Only this one is good. This one is bad. This one is bad. This one is bad. You are not a judge.
Wewe si hakimu.
Nobody made you judge.
Hakuna mtu ambaye alifanya kuwa wewe.
Preach the gospel.
Hubiri injili.
Leave judgment to God.
Achia Mungu hukumu.
There is this man.
Kuna huyu mtu.
Was having a farm.
Ambaye alikuwa na shamba.
In his farm.
Katika shamba lake.
He went to the following.
with
tears. And then the worker told the boss, we have to go, make sure we remove every strange what? Seed or crop. The owner said no. Because by removing the evil crops, you can make mistake and remove the best. Let them grow together. When the time comes, the owner will come and now will do the harvest. You have not been sent to the harvest. You are going to harvest. You preach the gospel. And when the master comes, it is up to him to know which one is better and which one is bad. We have churches where when people go, they don't even feel comfortable. When you are a man, somebody comes to church, the way you look at the person feels embarrassed. But it's just the way you look at the person. Let people come to Jesus.
Watch out for
Jesus. Let people come to Jesus. Let people come to Jesus. The way they are. I remember one day. You
were
going to doing evangelism. We met a brother. He was smoking, you know, secretly. So when he saw us from far and he was smoking, he removed the cigarette and put in the pocket because he thought if he threw it away we are going to see.
So
put in the pocket believing that the fire is going to go off. So we came and we greeted the brother. So the brother was just suspicious. And we didn't know he had a secret. So we asked him, how are you? So the guy is just uncomfortable. So we didn't know there is fire inside the pocket. Hallelujah. Jesus is your Lord. And what's wrong with the brother? And then we saw smoke here coming out. So, brother, what is this? You are dressed badly. You see this? It is badly. See that? What is this? We saw the cigarette.
Do
you know that that brother, he stopped smoking from that day until today? But what he saw challenged him and he decided, I will never
smoke.
You want to become a celebrity? You want your time, your world to celebrate you? You have to know that the world has a standard. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
People don't succeed in a vacuum. The manufacturer understands what I'm talking about. They will manufacture stuff, take to the Bureau of
Standards.
They will look to see if the standard is okay. If what you have done, what you have produced, is consumable or not. And if they put a stamp there, it means it's okay to people will consume it. One as if you. So you do things in an excellent way. Do things, put all your mind there. The Bible says whatever you do, whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your mind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do it with all your mind. pesa kwa church. Hapana. Give and it will be given. You see, Jesus even doesn't say, and God will give you. Can you put it there? Luke chapter 6, verse number 38. Give and it will be given to you. And when you go to the original language to say give, do you know what it means? Give and it will be given to you. Oh, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you. We have people in this life. They offer nothing. They have the attitude of defeated people. They walk like defeated people. When you look at them, their aspect, their physical aspect, their appearance, automatically they are defeated. Before you ask them even a question, automatically you look at them, they are failures. Now, they are in charge. And they say, hallelujah, I shall be the head. And all the dead. Give and you shall be given. Do you know what it means? Give. What are you giving? Let us be realistic. Watu hawainuki kwa hewa. Wanainuka kwa kile wanapeana katika ulimwengu zao. Katika siku zao. What you give to your generation, what you give to your world, determines what you become in this life. And also in the kingdom of God. What you supply, what you give to the kingdom, decide what you become also in the kingdom of God. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego told the king, we will not worship your idol. God will save us. Even if he doesn't save us, we want you to know, we will not worship your idol. We better die with God than live with an idol. So when they were thrown in the fire, the Bible says, the king looked into the fire. He saw the fourth human being. And he said to his people, how many people did we throw into the fire? But I see now four people. And the fourth one is appearance, is aspect, is like the Son of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
From today, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, come out of the fire. Come out. Now we have realized your God is a true God. From today, in this land, everybody will worship the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Standard. Standard. If your standard is fake, if your standard cannot bless your people, if the standard cannot, Pastor Richard, I hope you understand better what I'm talking about. Even Gideon, you are a professor, you understand better. When we talk about market, in French we say la loi de la demande, n'est-ce pas? Et tu recevoir. Demandez quoi? L'offre et la demande. L'offre et la demande. Hallelujah. It means in the market, you have the demands. People have needs. People have needs. What are you offering? What solution do you have? You don't have solution. You just cry, shout, and judge. I shall be the head. I shall know the head from where? The head from where? If we tell you these things, we don't get it. We don't get it. Jonah, ama Yohana, watu wakatoroka. Wanatembea mchungaji kuna ngozi. Kama mwanaka.
Yes.
Anakula zini. Mpapani. watu wanakula chapati wakienda anamondani nini kizazi ya nyoka watu wasema hey, sisi ni watoto wa Abrahamu tunakuwa juu kizazi ya nyoka. Yesu anaenda anasema come to me, Matthew chapter 21, chapter 11 verse 28 and 29, come to me you people have been rejected, come to me. Ama na mwana gani?
Yes.
Why are we going to let it? Ziara ni mwana. Come to me.
Jioni kwa
people who are tired.
Watu ambao wamechoka.
I came for you.
Nilikuja kwa ajili.
Come to me.
Kujeni kwa
people who are rejected.
Watu ambao wamekataliwa.
Come to me.
Jioni kwa
the society has rejected you.
Jamii imewakataa.
I've come for you.
Nimekuja kwa ajili.
The Bible says.
Ile inasema.
Jesus entered the house of Matthew.
Yesu akaingia katika nyumba ya Mathayo.
All the tax collectors called each other.
Watoza ushuru wakaitana kwa wingi.
House was packed of tax collectors.
Ikajaa watoza ushuru.
Hallelujah.
Kumbe na mtoto.
In the ministry of Jesus.
Sasa kuna Yesu.
And all tax collectors have money.
Na unajua watu wako na hela.
They will give money to the kingdom.
Watatoa pesa hizi kwa ufalme.
The ministry of Jesus is expanding.
Huduma ya Yesu inaendelea kuongezeka.
The first is looking to their child.
Just the same way
he wants God to utilize you. What is the price you're paying?
What are you paying?
What are you doing for kingdom's
sake?
Paul says, I prayed. I prayed. I fasted. And fasted. I don't know, is it the first, 2 Corinthians chapter 11? In toil and hardship, through many a sleepless night, in hunger and thirst, often without food, in cold and exposure. My God. Now give us the one that said, I know a man in Christ Jesus. Is it 12 or what? Look at that. I know a man in Christ who 14 years ago was caught up to the third heaven, whether in the body or out of the body. I do not know. God knows. 3. And I know that this man was caught up into paradise, whether in the body or out of the body. I do not know. God knows. You know, and he heard things that cannot be told, which men may not utter. One as few.
Amen.
One as few.
Amen.
Look at me.
That's how you can.
When I give you the truth, sometimes you don't like the truth. You like preachers who excite you. When they tell me,